Hello, in this video I'm going to show you how to install Scrapy and Anaconda on Mac. So first of all, we start on Google, Anaconda Python download, and we get to this page. So we go to download Anaconda free. Of course we're on Mac operating system here, and we can choose Python version 3.6. Okay, we can close this dialog and wait for it to download. So now you might be wondering, why Anaconda really? The answer is because it's a nice system that has tons of packages pre-compiled for us, and we can see some of them here. So Python 3.6 for Mac, and so we can easily install all those without having to do strange compilation processes. We will never need to compile from source, and this is why we would prefer Anaconda when we want to get started easily. So you can now run the downloaded package, continue, continue, continue. We will use the defaults. Okay, install, and installation starts. So after a bit, writing file starts. And don't trust the estimated time, it goes down much faster. In just a couple of minutes, it gets to the end. Okay, so installation finished. You might want to install the Microsoft Visual Studio, or you might not. I will skip it and close. And that was it. Installation completed. Okay, now to run Anaconda, you just open the terminal. So you press Command Space and you open the terminal. Alternatively, you can use the launchpad and write terminal here. So right now, if I write Scrapy here, we will see it doesn't work. And let's go to Scrapy installation and we will find out why. So here's the installation guide, and we can see that when we use Anaconda, we have to install this explicitly with this command. So we copy this one and we paste it here. Okay, so this takes a few seconds, then we press yes. Download starts, installation happens. And now Scrapy works. Good. So now it's time for us to understand where we are exactly. So if I type pwd, we will see we are on this directory, /users/look-forward. This will have your username here. So right now if I do cd desktop, now I will be on the desktop directory. This means that if I create a directory here, for example, Scrapy, or let's do it programmatically, mkdir scrapy, a new directory will be created in here. Okay, so we can see here there is one-to-one correspondence of where we are in the command line. We can see where we are with pwd and what happens on those directories, for example, on desktop. And now we can go inside the Scrapy directory. Okay, with ls we can see all the files in this directory. You can see right now this is empty. So these are basic commands that we will use quite often. And so let's have a look here. Again, I came here through Scrapy installation, but now let's use Scrapy tutorial, which is exactly below installation on the same side. So we're installation, we could go here tutorial and we can follow the tutorial. So we can see here the first step that they say is Scrapy start project tutorial, and let's see what happens if we do that here. Scrapy start project tutorial, I just run this one, and we can see here that Scrapy created for us a directory structure. So these are a few files. We will not have to modify them now, but we can move now into this tutorial directory, cd tutorial, or equivalently double click here. If I press ls, you will see that says script.config tutorial, which is exactly what I see on the right hand side here. That's good. So that was the first step here, and then it tells us to go to the directory tutorial spiders and create a file called spider.py. So we can do this by using our favorite text editor, and I will use TextMate. So over here we go file, save as, and I go desktop, script.tutorial, and then spiders. And in this directory we want to save a file with this name. Okay, let's save it. And now we should be able to see it in the directory structure over here, tutorial spiders, quote spider.py. This is exactly what we need to see. And then the tutorial tells us to copy paste this code in here. Okay, we copy it. And then we paste it. Okay, looks good. And now we would expect this little scraper to work. And how do we run it? It tells us down here, scrapy crawl quotes. So we're in this directory and we run scrapy crawl quotes, and notice what will happen right now. So we can see some things run over here on the terminal. This was our first scrapy crawl, and at the same time two files got generated here, quotes 1 and quotes 2. These correspond to those pages that this crawler describes as start requests. So if we go here, we will see quotes to scrape, Einstein, etc. And now if we drag and drop quotes 1 here, we'll see exactly the same thing in text format. And this is exactly what the code here does. It opens those URLs, then gets the output and saves the body of the text on those files. So these are the first steps of the tutorial. It demonstrates that the installation works successfully. You can continue with the rest of the tutorial. It should be relatively easy. And this will help you because you will become more familiar with those directories, folders, and also with using your text editor. We're going to use those tools and primitives quite a few times as we develop more complex spiders. So in this video, we'll learn quite a lot. We learned how to install Anaconda, how to install Scrapy. We followed the basic steps on the tutorials, and we made sure we could use basic commands on the terminal and also run our first scraping job. Thanks a lot and have fun.